It's Kim coming to you from the heart of Cube Farm USA with today's Cube News. I want to give a shout out to my friend Amy. She sent me this wonderful email with some very good news, y'all. As of today, she is a boss. She got promoted. Her employer cleared out the stockroom closet, made it her office, and as of 9 a.m. tomorrow morning, she's going to be overseeing 5 employees. But Amy has some trepidation. Kim, I have no idea what kind of boss personality I'm going to wind up being, and I am scared. I'm going to make everybody hate me. Please advise. Advise I will. Amy, listen up. Most bosses can be grouped under one of 3 different personalities. Let's take you through them. Let's talk about the insecure boss. They're so damn defensive and afraid that everybody's going to find out that he or she is a fraud that they view every suggestion and question like it is an assault on their personality. Oh, what are you saying? That I can't lead? That I can't make a decision? That I don't know what I'm doing? No, you're saying that. You give me a migraine. Listen, here's a suggestion for you insecure bosses who are listening out there. Take our suggestions. It's a win-win because if it's a good suggestion, you're going to take credit anyway. And if it's a crappy suggestion, you're going to have our heads and get to blame us. Now, the other side of that coin is the overconfident boss. This is the micromanager. This one's got everybody on little strings. Ooh, look at me. I can pull your string, pull your string, pull your string. Makes me feel like some sort of puppet in a marionette show. Listen up, all you overconfident, string-pulling, pain-in-the-ass puppet master bosses. Don't you yank my chain just because you can. Make me feel psychotic and dizzy. You also got yourself the undesirable deadbeat absentee boss. Oh, this one is never around. This is a deadbeat. I know that sounds like it should be fun, but it's not. And let me tell you why. They are not there to answer questions, answer phones, make meetings. They're not there for their vendors. They're not there for you. They're not even there for their own boss, which means that you're stuck covering their ass. Where is it? Where? I don't know. Can you run the meeting without him? Oh, sure, I can run the meeting without him. Sure. Don't be this kind of boss, because if you are, everyone will hate you. All is not woeful. There is one kind of boss out there that is just a fantabulous kind of boss to be. I like to call it the Buddha boss. Because that boss is enlightened. The Buddha boss lets their employees be themselves, do their job. The Buddha boss gives you an assignment and lets you go your way. And if you screw up, she'll tell you you screwed up and you fix it. Listen, the Buddha boss is very, well, zen about all this stuff. She realizes that the stronger her employees are, the better she's gonna look. It ain't more complicated than that. Ooh, the Buddha boss is a delight to work for. Let that be you, Amy. Let me know how it goes. Buddha boss. You the boss, Buddha boss. It's got a nice ring to it.